Oh, let's go, baby. This morning, get online, share this shit. My greatest thing. Doc Spills with your morning blow. Listen, do me this. Hashtag somebody. Add somebody to this live. Today we're going to talk about your voice and why it's important. I want to start this live off by saying, many of you don't even know how much of a masterpiece you are. How much of priceless masterpiece you are. I've counseled people for more than 20 years. And you know what I can tell you? I can tell you that people know little about themselves on the positive side, but they know everything that's wrong with them on the negative side. I've counseled people for years, and I can tell you this. I can tell you right now that you know more about your flaws than you do about your virtues. We've been trained to see them. We've been trained to see our imperfections. recognize these imperfections, and then we use these imperfections against our own selves, not knowing that we are perfect imperfections, and it is in our imperfections that we are truly perfect. It is not perfection that we look for. It should be imperfection that we look for. For in imperfection, we see perfection. How can you say that? How can you say we see perfection in imperfection? Because it's in the imperfection where your uniqueness is. Your flaw is what makes you unique, not your virtue. What makes you powerful is that you have a flaw and you still functioning. How about this? How about you celebrate that you are a functioning flaw? How about you clap for yourself right now and realize that you are a functioning flaw? That no matter how fucked up you are, you should celebrate the fact that you're still functioning. There's a whole bunch of other people that didn't make it through what you made it through, and you're still functioning. And that function that's in you should put faith in you to keep going. Why? Because that function, that malfunction, that dysfunction, that misfunction is really your function for how you will reach others. You reach others through your flaws, not your virtues. The average man just wants to know if he can relate to you. The average woman just wants to know, will you judge her? People will put their guards down if they could just be them. And then you would hear their real voices. But we'll never hear their real voices, will we? We will only hear the voices that they became as a result of who they suppressed. Who are you? Who has made you sacrifice your voice for acceptance? Who has made you sacrifice your flaws and think that they are really things that make you a bad person, when we all have flaws, don't we? Aren't we all screwed up? Aren't we all fucked up? Don't we all have shit that's wrong with us? Who can judge? Hashtag Doc Spills Live. Hashtag Morning Blow. Somebody on here needs to recognize you have a voice and it should be heard. And it's the voice of a flawed person. It's the voice of a person who, let me say this to you, it's the voice of a person who, for all intents and purposes, your flaws makes you unique. Isn't it something that what's in the museum now is broken pieces? Have you ever noticed that museums, carry history? Isn't that something? That in some of the most expensive, museums in the world, they all carry broken pieces. Did you catch that? Some of the most expensive museums in the world carry history. Make sure you hear this. And that history is in broken pieces. Did you hear me? That history is broken pieces. Isn't it amazing how museums treasure broken pieces? But people won't treasure your broken life. Isn't it amazing how museums honor history, but no one wants to remember yours? History is celebrated when it's an antique, but it is talked about when it is fresh. There's a painter by the name of Vincent van Gogh. For all intents and purposes, Van Gogh is now known by his great exploits in his abstract paintings and in many of his drawings. The unfortunate thing about Vincent van Gogh, what many of you don't know, is that during his lifetime, he was never considered a master artist. All of his paintings were not deemed masterpieces until after Van Gogh died. It's amazing that they didn't see his virtue until after they found out that no one could do what he did. Van Gogh was a masterful artist the whole time. See, what was wrong with Van Gogh is he wasn't lost. He was just simply undiscovered. I need to speak to 50 of you right now. You're Van Gogh. You're not lost. You're just undiscovered. Soon somebody's gonna recognize your voice. Soon someone's gonna recognize your voice. Just continue to speak. And don't be shy about your history. Everybody got a fucked up past. Somebody's gonna see you. Now the question is, when they see you, would you put the work in? When they see you, will you have something to say? Did you work on your craft in private so when you finally have a chance to speak, you will sound like you deserve to be heard? Your voice is important. And when your voice is heard, never forget your past, because your past is how you relate. Never forget your past, because your past without it makes you become self-righteous. Never forget your past, because without your past, you become an ungrateful, fucked up motherfucker. You forget who you were, what God saved you from, what God delivered you from, and you'll be quick to judge somebody else and silence their voice because it doesn't sound like yours. I need you to hear me this morning. You're important. Your voice is significant. You have something to say, and you deserve to be heard. Now, I know your parents didn't hear you. I know your siblings didn't hear you. Maybe your husband won't hear you, or your wife won't listen. Maybe your children won't listen. Maybe none of them are listening because you've never listened to yourself. See, when you listen to your own voice and your voice becomes important, then others will hear your voice. When what you say becomes important to you, you won't let others run over your voice when it's time to be heard. You see how that works? See, your voice don't matter to you, so your voice don't matter to nobody else. But when your voice begins to matter to you, nobody's voice will shut you down. See, it's the voice. That's the power. Now remember these words. The voice you trust is critical to your success. I leave you on this morning, bloke, with my boy, Lil Rod Wave. I hope this morning, bloke, put you in a mind frame of saying, I have a voice, and it needs to be heard. Even if you're splitting verbs, you can still be heard. From the hood, you can be heard. From the ghetto, you can be heard. From Peru, you can be heard. From Iraq, you can be heard. From Acres Home, you can be heard. From Brazil, you can be heard. From the UK, you can be heard. You could be in some bush country, somewhere where nobody knows your name in Africa, and you still can be heard. Can't nobody silence you if you really want to be heard. Today, speak up, motherfucker. Hashtag, speak up, MF. Yeah, hashtag, speak up, MF. That's your hashtag. Speak up, motherfucker. That's your hashtag. I'm tired of you being silent. I'm tired of people punking you. I'm tired of people running over you. Speak up. Speak the fuck up. Speak up. And when your voice matters to you, then it'll start mattering to others. This your morning blow from your OG. And you know how we always do it. Fire up, niggas. Fire that motherfucking up. I'm so excited to know it. I'm so excited to know it. Speak up, motherfuckers. Speak up. Don't be nobody's bitch today. Speak up. Don't be nobody's bitch today. Speak up. Don't be nobody's bitch today. Speak up, man. Speak the fuck up. Or else somebody's gonna speak for you. Just like always.